And now, a vintage tale of mystery, suspense, and adventure from the pages of Black Mask. Blackstone Audio presents Black Mask Audio Magazine, a series of classic hard-boiled crime stories dramatized by the award-winning Hollywood Theater of the Ear. From the April 1934 issue of Black Mask, a thriller by Paul Cain entitled Trouble Chaser.
It was about 9 o'clock when I got to May Jackman's Hollywood apartment, and the party hadn't got going. I mean, nobody was falling down, and nobody had been smacked over the skull with a bottle. Yet.
Hey, Ray, come stai? I didn't think you were coming.
Tony was Italian, from Genoa, I think. I'd introduced Tony to May when she was still a movie extra, and not doing so well at it.
Let me fix you a drink, compadre.
They'd been living together for about a year.
Red, darling, give us a big hug and kiss.
Hey, not that big.
May was demonstrative with everybody when she had 2 or 3 fifths of gin under her belt.
We've got to get rid of Tony.
I looked at her with what I hoped would penetrate her gin haze as an extremely disgusted expression.
I mean, for a minute. Tony, we're out of ice. Go knock on Cora's door and see if she's got any.
Okay, Carl.
I want to show you something, Red. Come with me.
May steered me through the short corridor into the bedroom. Whatever's on your pickled mind, spill it fast. I don't want your hothead boyfriend catching us in here.
Take a look at this.
What is it?
What does it look like?
An ordinary check.
Look at the signature.
Louis L. Steinlin.
The head of Astro Motion Pictures. His personal check for $2,500.
That's swell, May.
It's swell, and it's gonna be a lot sweller.
So?
So, this is the amount of your cut for helping me.
Helping you do what?
Make a deal with Steinlin, dummy.
What the hell are you talking about?
We're going to sell Louis his 2-bit check for $25,000. This little piece of paper is worth its weight in radium.
Yeah?
Steinlin's been chasing me for months. Last weekend, Tony went up to Frisco on business. I went to Arrowhead with Steinlin. Also on business, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, monkey business.
This is a little token of the deal.
Quite a token.
Peanuts! We're going to sell it back to him.
Blackmail?
Not really. I'd never do that. But... you know who he's married to, don't you? Sheila Dale, Astra Studios' brightest star. You'd know that if you read the columns. And you'd also know that Sheila Dale is as volatile as a landmine. If she saw this, look out. I simply want to offer Louis Steinlin the chance to correct his indiscretion by exchanging the check for cash.
10 times the cash.
He can afford it.
What do you need me for?
Steinlin's one of those jerks that'll take a man seriously, but not a woman.
Why don't you have Tony work with you on this?
Don't be a sap, Red. If Tony knew about this or found out about it, he'd cut my throat. Literally. You know how he gets. I'm through with that guy anyway. As soon as I collect my little windfall, it's off to Europe for me. And he can go find another dame to whack around.
Is why you were bugging me to show up tonight?
Yeah. Well, what do you think?
What do I think? I think you're crazy. You're crazy to figure beating Steinlin out of anything, and to pull it off without Tony getting wise. He watches you like a hawk. On top of which, even the bats in your belfry could have told you that I'd want nothing to do with blackmail, even for a million. And certainly not this dumb scheme. In case you forgot, my job is to keep people out of trouble, not help them get into it.
All right, Red, don't get your panties in a bunch.
Let's get back to the party before Tony sees us in your bedroom and blows his stack.
Wait a minute, Red.
What?
I know I don't have to tell you to keep this under your hat.
Stay out of trouble, May. And settle for the 25 C notes. At that price, you're all...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.